Dark Fox, more content on Metal Gear Solid Survive. I want to say this is mission 4. We're getting more information from the node and taking it back to base. So, without further ado, here we go. Alright, so we're starting here on the other side of the base. We're going to be going up towards that huge broken facility over there. And so, if you guys haven't already seen the beginning of it, it shows Mother Base from Metal Gear Solid 5. It shows it being pulled into a wormhole. And I'm sure that was one of the pieces that got drug into it. And the further you get along, you'll see wormholes opening up all over the place, dropping supplies. So, me, myself, I wouldn't recommend going to those because it's going to attract those wanderers. So, I wouldn't recommend going to them. But if you do see them, just know that it's supplies that are coming available. So it's pretty quiet. Pretty quiet when you go in. You can take your time, collect whatever, you know, whatever is in these busted quad cons over here. You take your time. It's some plants over here. There's wood over there. You know, you're just, you know, walking on sunshine going through here. And the first time going through it, I didn't know you could break those. I'm sure I'm not the only one, but I feel pretty stupid just because, you know, I should have known better, you know. And make sure, if you're going to use your skills often, it does take away stamina and all that. So here we got a dead body. And so in the first video, I mentioned that I don't think the dead turn into these things. And I said that based on seeing that dead person right there. Seeing that guy that was, you know, dead to rights. He's not a wanderer, and I don't think he's going to turn into water. Data acquired from memory board. And boom, there it is. They start falling off this cliff, dude. It creeped me out. I was like, oh god, I'm going to die. I'm going to die. They're all running, blah, 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 blah. But no, they all don't have legs. So they're pretty easy pickings. And I think I found out from this walkthrough right here that if you hit them right in the head, it's almost an insta-kill. With, you know, with you having the pipe. And then, you know, a lot's going on at this time. You know, it's a lot that's going on. So you can get freaked out and just not aim for the head because you don't know. You're like, oh my god, I gotta get out of here. And then you're backing up while you're freaking stabbing. And so it gets kind of, I guess, nerve-wracking, you know. It can be nerve-wracking, but not horribly so because, I mean, they're crawling. You know, we know crawling walkers are a danger because you'll just forget about them. But they, you know, by themselves, it's almost sad. It's almost sad, you know. But they are there to do one thing, and that's to tear the flesh from your bones. So they have to be dealt with. You gotta deal with them. And so right now I'm just collecting that Kuban energy. As of this point, I haven't sent any back yet. I think I haven't developed that wormhole transport yet. But you're able to develop that, I want to say quite soon. And you can start sending animals back to your base. If you have a farm, or not farm, but animal enclosure, it'll send them right to that. So you'll have those animals there. So periodically you can pass by there, you know, grab meat, grab milk. As I come to find out, I didn't know this at the beginning. I just thought you were just dropped down to this place with nothing. With, I mean, essentially that's true. You're picking up all your stuff as you go along, but I was looking for that marker right there. But you're essentially picking up all this stuff as you go along, and you know, there's no one really there to help. You know, you're by yourself. Even the guy, I want to say Reeves is his name. Even the guy you're stuck there with, he's hurt right now, so he's not much of a help as you complete your missions. Going back to base, pulled that information from that node, collected the Kuban energy, and that's that. We're gonna let Virgil do its thing.
With this memory board data, another phase of my memory restoration is complete. You can now craft an air tank. I detect a memory board within the dust.
Of course you can.
Begin your search.
Into the dust.
You've prepared an air tank. You can now enter the dust.
Having crafted an air tank, you can now operate within the dust. However, the tank is only so big. If the oxygen in it runs out, your life will begin to drop. If you're low on oxygen, you can use Kuban energy to replenish it. You can take advantage of this feature from your iDroid.
All right, guys, that was it for, I want to say, mission 4. So just to recap, you went into the valley. It was all, you know, freaking awesome. And then you come out, and then all of a sudden, all these no-legged wanderers start coming after you. Pretty easy, pretty simple. Not a hard mission. That was one of the easier ones. And so you get back, you're able to craft the air tank, and now you're ready to go into the dust. But if you like this video, go ahead and give it a like. If you really liked it, go ahead and subscribe. And if you really, really liked it, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. It's been Dark Fox. You guys, peace.